It's October 28th, 2021. I'm in Utica, New York on Schuyler Street. 40 degrees. And NYS&W number 3040 is bringing its train southbound on Schuyler. The high cube boxcars will be headed to Oneida Warehouse in New Hartford on Campion Road, former Mohawk Containers. Looks like it just might be one boxcar this morning. The train is nearing Noise Street. The Noise Street marks the southerly end of street trackage on Schuyler Street. I'm at the very end of the former Utica division of the New York, Ontario, and Western, just past Estates Drive in New Hartford. As you can see, there's a track machine at the stub end of the tracks. It's actually October 29th. I misspoke earlier, saying it was the morning of October 28th. In order for the Susquehanna to switch that boxcar at New Hartford's Oneida Warehouse, they've got to come off the Utica main line. They enter for a short while former West Shore tracks and will, about a half mile or so after entering former West Shore tracks, there's a switch on to what was the Utica division of the New York, Ontario, and Western, which was abandoned in 1957. But the Delaware, Lackawanna, and Western bought a portion of it up to this point in order to serve industries along Campion Road in New Hartford. The O&W tracks actually went a little bit farther from the current endpoint. Probably about 0.2 of a mile farther south, but over the years the railroad pulled up some of the rails beyond this point. Some are still in the trees or in the woods beyond here. But when I was much younger, in my teens, I used to explore these tracks and walk all the way to the end of the line, which was again about 0.2 of a mile from here. There was just a simple dirt hump where they stopped pulling up the rails back in 1957. Here's a better look at the switch and the tracks back to Oneida Warehouse in New Hartford. They received 500-pound bales of paper, I believe. And there's a pile of the new ties waiting to be installed here. The train will shortly be crossing New York State Route 840. They've got to stop there and make sure the traffic light is activated before going across. It's a very busy crossing, and I've been told there have been times when there have been some accidents here. It's a 55 mile per hour highway, and you can see the cars are zinging by pretty quickly. There's actually a signal on a pole that'll turn green so the crew will know when it's okay to proceed across the State Highway 840. There'll be two more crossings they'll go over before they're reaching the State's Drive. One is Old Campion Road, and the one closest to me is Wilbur Road. There is a big Niagara Mohawk facility on the other side of the tracks at the end of Wilbur Road. You just saw National Grid truck pass by. Of course, it was Niagara Mohawk for many years before. I think the most boxcars they can bring up here, because the end of track is near, it's just right beyond the State's Drive, I think they can do four before they run out of room. Yeah. see the conductor just detrained. He'll throw the switch as soon as the train is clear of it. Climbing on that boxcar for the shove move back to the customer in New Hartford. Approximately a half mile to three quarters of a mile. The shove move will also include crossing a busy four-lane highway, New York State Routes 5 and 12. And the sun angle is atrocious here in the morning, but this is Oneida Warehouse, New Hartford. I'm along Campion Road. 3040 is backed into the structure. Has one load this morning. There may be a couple empties in there that they'll be pulling out. One boxcar they'd be spotting this morning. Thank you. the former New Hartford station of the Delaware, Lackawanna, and Western Railroad at 2643 Genesee Street in South Utica. In the early 1920s, the city of Utica, by referendum, was able to take possession of a big chunk of New Hartford. But the DL&W never renamed this station. It always remained as New Hartford. It's currently the beer hub. Again, these tracks are part of the New York Susquehanna and Western's Utica to Binghamton mainline.